Today, I will be discussing scan implementation for high performance design using the ScanPro. This is the agenda for today's talk. We'll start with discussing some scan challenges. Then we'll discuss the scan architecture we have at NVIDIA. We'll go through the scan implementation flow overview. We'll discuss scan implementation, effective scan implementation, test point implementation, and then end with some results. Scan challenges. So as we know, with each new chip, design sizes keep increasing. And larger design size means more number of scan channels or larger scan chain, which lead to the more test data volume, more test time, and hence more memory for the ATE. It also makes the scan insertion complex and the timing closure difficult. Also, larger design means more switching activity and hence more IR drop. Also, it is difficult to manage the test interface with larger design because as design size increases, the number of test pin either remains the same or it actually not increase in the same proportion. Thanks to the SSN, that's how the test interface issue. The next scan challenge is the asymmetrical floor plan and tiling. So not all the blocks are symmetrically floor plan in the physical design, and that poses some scan challenges. Then the complex power domain scenario, we have to deal with a complicated power domain scenario in the scan insertion, and that poses some scan implementation challenges. The DFT optimal area to achieve the higher test coverage, we have to consider the DFT optimal area. We have to take care that we are not adding too much of the DFT logic to achieve the high test coverage. Scan congestion. Scan congestion can happen because of different regions, and those has to be addressed in the, those are the scan challenges has to be addressed in the scan implementation. And lastly, the test time and quality. We have to maintain high quality scan testing while minimizing the test time. This is the scan architecture we have at NVIDIA. We have a sub-block. Sub-block is a soft micro, or it could be a hard IP or soft IP. It's a scan inserted IP. And on top of that, we have a block. Block contain sub-block, the functional logic, and all the DFT logic. On top of the block, we have a cluster. Cluster is nothing but you can call it a wrapper or DFT core. We do the ADPG at the cluster level. And we also have a hierarchical cluster shown in the right side of the picture. This is the scan implementation flow overview. We start with the DFT analysis at the cluster level, where we extract all the clock reset control port or the boundary port information of the cluster to the sub-block and the block. Once we extract these information from cluster to the sub-block or block, then we perform the sub-block scan insertion. Sub-block scan insertion go through the different scan insertion step. Start with design preparation. Design preparation is like loading the design and the DFT constraint, and then perform the DRC, design rule check, and then TP analysis, WBR analysis, and define the scan mode. And at the end, we perform the insert test logic. Once sub-block scan insertion is completed, we move to the block-level scan insertion. Block-level scan insertion, again, go through the same scan insertion step, starting from the design prep, go all the way to the insert test logic. And at the end, we do the power analysis, where we insert the level shifter and clamp based on the power domain. The first step and the last step is done using the internal tool. The insertion step is we use the Tessent ScanPro to perform the scan insertion. Now let's discuss efficient use of the core wrapping. So we insert the wrapper for the cluster level port. So during the DFT analysis, we map all the cluster level port to the sub block and block, and those are the only port to get the WBR, and the WBR are inserted inside the block or sub block. So by doing so, we reduce the logic for the ripping. So only the port of the block or sub block, which actually go all the way to the cluster level, get the ripper sail. Not all the port of the block actually get the ripper sail. So that actually minimizes the core ripping area. Also, we use high threshold to identify the shared ripper. That reduces the DFT logic DFT area and improve the timing. Since we insert the ripper for the cluster level port, so we perform the X test between the clusters. Core ripping or concurrent testing of the cluster. So since we insert the core ripper for the cluster level port, so we are able to perform the concurrent testing of the hierarchical core. So like in the picture two, where we have the cluster two and on top of there is cluster one, and both cluster can be tested concurrently. That required less number of ATPG mode, less ATPG pattern, and lesser test time. Traditionally, these cluster are tested serially. The cluster two tested first and then the cluster one, and that required more number of ATPG mode and more ATPG mode test time. So having the core ripping at the cluster level, be able to perform the concurrent testing of the hierarchical core hierarchical cluster. Power aware scan implementation. So we minimize the power domain crossing of scan path. Also, WBR is added for each power domain. If the dedicated are added, if the shared threshold are increased, and we insert the single dedicated if the dedicated threshold increase. We have different threshold. If it is the threshold is increased, then we insert the dedicated, and if the dedicated threshold increase, then we insert the single in always on power domain. There are multiple core ripping exclusion applied. So these are the core ripping exclusion for the cluster level port, which actually map to the block or sub block. So we do not insert the core ripper for the feed through or the combinational logic path. Feed through or combinational logic path does not get the core ripper in the block where it is actually the feed through or combo. But it gets the ripper in other block where actually it ended to the some sequential cell. Also, the multi-cycle path, we exclude the core ripping for the multi-cycle path. Those are the timing critical path. Those are not part of the scan chain. So we do not insert the dedicated ripper cell on the multi-cycle path or fast path. Non-scan are supposed to be functional during the test. I mean, not all of them, but most of the non-scan logic are supposed to be functional during the test. So we do not insert the ripper on the non-scan logic as well, even if it is a cluster level port. We only insert the shared ripper for the timing critical path, even if exceeded the threshold. So we force the Tessent ScanPro to insert the shared only for the timing critical port. Dedicated are added for the port for the non-timing critical path where the shared threshold are actually exceeded. Efficient use of the test point. So we do not insert the test point beyond the certain logic depth. So we define the certain logic depth we have. We get it from the timing team that these are the logic depth. If we have the logic depth, such logic depth, then we do not have to insert the TP on those cases. Also, we do the slack-based test point insertion so that timing critical path does not get the any TP based on the slack. IO path are always timing critical, so IO path are also excluded to get the any test point. We insert some focus TP. Focus TP is like we use the higher test point budget for the logic, impact the pattern count and ATPG coverage. And for the complex block where the test point analysis taking too much time, there we actually enable the multi-threading to reduce the runtime. Now let's discuss some scan congestion issue we address in using the ScanPro. So there are some tiling block, or there are the block which are actually dominated with the sub block. In those cases, your long scan route are actually formed, and the scan depth in those cases does not help much. So to address the scan congestion issue in the tiling or the sub block dominated block, we define these sub block as a physical during the insertion to make sure the stitching happen within that sub block. That reduces the scan congestion, long route scan congestion. We still have some long route scan but those are for the scan debug mode. This increases the compression ratio because we need a little more endpoint, codec endpoint, but that's not actually a big concern. So the scan congestion we can address in these kind of the block, the tiling block or sub-block dominated block by defining these sub-block as a physical in the insertion. Another congestion issue comes from EDT to the sub-block. So there are some sub-block in which the some scan chain are active in one scan mode and the bypass in the other scan mode. Those are like bypass scan scan chain population. So those actually add so many muxes for the decode logic and create a lot of scan congestion from the EDT to the sub-block. So to address it, we define those scan population, we call it bypass scan population, as a immutable chain family. Means we define a dedicated endpoint for those scan population. And that reduces the number of muxes from 1,000 to the 100. And it actually also minimizes the congestion. This again comes by minor increase in the compression ratio. Now let's discuss some the core ripping results. So I choose four block here. So like block A, the total number of port is having 2,630. Out of that, we are inserting the wrapper only for 430 port. These 431 port are reaching to the cluster level. So these are the only port getting the wrapper. And since we are using the high threshold, so we are mostly inserting the shared wrapper. So only 16% of the port of the block A getting the wrapper. In the block B, none of the port reaching to the cluster boundary. So none of them are getting the wrapper. In the block C, we have a 71 port reached to the cluster boundary, and those are getting the wrapper shell. And out of that, all of them are getting the wrapper because of high threshold. Block D, which is actually huge in size, so we are able to wrap only the 64% of the port getting the wrapper. And that is actually not adding, we are not adding too much actual logic for the wrapper cell by inserting the wrapper only for the cluster port. These are the test point results. So without using the any TP, the number of pattern is very high, as you can see in block A, having 47K pattern count. But once we enable the TP and insert the 2% of the TP, then we are able to reduce the pattern count by 74% to 1,200K round. In the block B, and same thing, with 2% TP, we're able to bring down the pattern count to 14K. In the block C, by 76%, and in block D, by 46%. So the test point without multi, so there are some complex block which actually take lot of TP analysis runtime. So in those cases, we enable the multi-threading. Multi-threading actually use the more number of licenses, so we do not enable it by default. That is enable case by case where the runtime is high. And once we enable the multi-thread, then the TP analysis runtime is come down by 30 to 40% in the different block, different size block. This is the runtime result of the different scan insertion step, starting from the setup, going all the way to the power insertion. So as you can see, the most of the time taken by the TP analysis, and in those blocks, using the multi-thread, we can reduce the TP analysis runtime by 30 to 40%. The block A, which having approximately 600K flop, we able to complete the insertion like in less than 3 hours. And similarly, the block B, which actually half of the size of the block A, so able to complete in 1 to 2 hours. So yeah, these are the runtime result of different size block for different steps. This is the memory usage for different step. We have in the insertion, starting from the setup, going all the way to the power hookup. So depend on the size of the block. So the block A is able to complete using the 27 GB of memory, and similarly the smaller block able to complete, I mean taking lesser time to complete the insertion, scan insertion. Okay, so the conclusion, so by using the minimizing the WBR, like inserting the WBR only for the cluster port, we are still able to achieve the high test coverage. Enabling the, by having the core ripping at the cluster level, we can perform the hierarchical cost testing. That again addresses the test time. By using the placement power and congestion aware scan implementation, we are able to minimize the scan congestion. By using the timing aware test point insertion, we are still able to reduce the pattern count and the test data volume. And at the end, by using the ScanPro, we are able to improve the test quality and test cost.